everybody. Come on in, come on in, come on in. Welcome, welcome, welcome back to SeLah's Spot, the hottest spot in America. Man, y'all make sure you guys drop some comments. Let me know you guys are watching. Make sure you share this video. So glad to be back with you guys on this evening. Of course, I am your host, Kaelin Levy. Man, we just thank God to be able to come back and broadcast to you guys, man. Once again, the hottest spot in America. We thank God for this platform. We thank God for the opportunity. And we thank God for you, man. So let's keep people rolling in here. Y'all make sure y'all put some hearts on the screen so we can make sure that we give you guys a proper SeLah's Spot shout out, okay? Let me know you guys are here. Let me know where you guys are watching from so I can give you guys a shout out, all right? So listen. We're not going to beat around the bush on tonight, man. We're going to give you guys the announcements. We're going to get straight into the word on tonight. But I do want to make sure you guys remember, listen, we encourage dialogue. We encourage you guys to comment on the live feed. We encourage you guys to drop some hearts on the screen. Listen, man, we've been doing this for a while with you guys, so we want to make sure you guys are comfortable. Please, please, by all means, go ahead and comment. Go ahead and give us your feedback, man. Let us know because we want to talk to you. We want to show you guys that SeLah's Spot love, all right? So what I'm going to do first, we have a very, very special person here with us on tonight, okay? She's going to help come up and help me out with these announcements. Y'all put some hearts on the screen, all right? We got our Chief Operating Officer, Miss Andrea Hollins, in the building. How you doing, Miss Andrea?
I'm well. How are you tonight?
Listen, I'm feeling good. I'm feeling good. We back on the spot.
Yes.
The people are back on the spot with us. I'm excited. Are you excited?
I'm very excited. Give us some hearts
put
tonight.
Put some hearts on the screen, man. Absolutely. Miss Andrea, it's been a while since you've been on the spot. Mm-hmm. Go ahead, in your own special way, go ahead and ask the people to put some hearts on the screen.
I would greatly appreciate the love, the warmth, the welcome back by showing, giving us some hearts.
Put some hearts on the screen, y'all. Absolutely, absolutely. So, we're going to kind of just, you know, of course, SeLah's Spot, man, we are here to give you the tea, all right? First off, we'll definitely want to give a huge shout out to our playwright, director, visionary producer of SeLah Productions Incorporated, Ms. JaVon, Ophelia, Butler. Shouts out to Ms. JaVon, man. Y'all put some hearts on the screen for her. Of course, always being a visionary, always being a leader, pushing the vision forward. So we just thank God for her, for just giving her the strength to continuing to carry this vision on. So shout out to Ms. JaVon, Ophelia Butler. Of course, she is always working. She misses you guys. Can't wait to see you guys again, all right? Miss Andrea, we have some things that we need to tell the people. You want to start off? You going to start off?
Yes,
go ahead. Do your thing. Ladies
first.
Thank
you for being a gentleman.
Absolutely.
Well, first of all, we want to tell you guys, of course, Colors is coming. The Ghanaian Nation, they are awaiting Miss JaVon. She's been blessed. She's been to Africa 5 times. Ooh. Since 2018. She is blessed. She's getting ready to travel back, actually. And so we're excited about Colors. I'm excited about my first trip to Africa, to go home, as they would say. I'm so excited. Kaelin, are you excited?
I'm excited, man. Super excited. Can't wait.
Yes. So the next thing is JaVon Ophelia's act. We are still looking for coaches for JaVon Ophelia's act. So if you have experience in teaching acting, singing, or dancing, call 225-623-9449 to schedule an interview. We'd love to interview you for JaVon Ophelia's act. That's our mentorship and learning program for the performing arts.
Absolutely. Yeah. JaVon Ophelia's act has blessed so many people, including myself. So once again, if you want to be a coach, acting, singing, dancing instructor, man, please, by all means, go ahead and schedule yourself an interview. Once again, that is 225-623-9449, okay? Now, she's talking about JaVon Ophelia's act, right? I want to take the middle part from that. I want to talk about Ophelia, okay?
Yes.
Ophelia, y'all, man, listen. We are still scheduling auditions, man. We have seen some wonderful, wonderful people. Listen, we want you to be a part of Ophelia, okay? If God puts it on your heart to come out and audition, please do so. We are still taking auditions for male and female drama roles. All you have to do is go ahead and dial 225-623-9449. Schedule yourself an audition, okay? And come down and see your people over at SeLah Productions Incorporated. Give it your best shot. We also, you can email your headshot to
SPI at SeLah Productions Incorporated. SeLah's.org.
Absolutely. Her headshot and your resume as well, right?
Yes.
Absolutely. So for all my aspiring actors and actresses out there, listen, hey, here at SeLah, we aspire to inspire, okay? So this is an opportunity for you to, as Ms. JaVon would always say, to run towards your vision. Run towards the vision that God has placed inside of you, and also to use your gifts to contribute to the kingdom of God, right? So once again, that's 225-623-9449. Go ahead and schedule, excuse me, an audition today. Don't waste another second, all right?
Yeah.
Also, real quickly, just want to, you know, talk to you guys, man, my SeLah Spot family. Listen, we thank you guys so, so much for joining us. Man, tonight we have a wonderful, wonderful word.
Yes.
Listen, we have so, so many things going on with SeLah Productions Incorporated. Okay, listen, if you would like to sow a seed into SeLah Productions Incorporated, there are many ways you can do so. You can use the Cash App. You can use PayPal, or you can go directly to our website, www.selahproductionsincorp.org. Go ahead and sow a seed. Of course, we always talk to you guys about naming your seed so that we can pray for you, man. SeLah, Ms. JaVon talks about it all the time, man. SeLah is some very, very fertile ground, and
yeah,
we're definitely going to talk a little bit about seed sowing on tonight. Miss Andrea, did you want to, I know you're going to give the information for if people would like to sow a seed.
Yes. If you'd like to sow a seed into SeLah Productions Incorporated, we have many ways. You can go through our website, www.selahproductionsincorp.org. At the bottom of the page, there is a yellow donate button. Mm-hmm. You can click that button, sow your $20 seed, and remember to name your seed.
Yes.
You can also Cash App it. That's $SeLah Productions INC, as well as PayPal. And PayPal is paypal.me/SeLah Productions INC.
Absolutely, absolutely. So guys, once again, listen, man, this is a season for grace and for favor, okay? Listen, go ahead, if you would like to sow a seed into SeLah Productions Incorporated and everything that we are doing for the kingdom, please go ahead and do so. Miss Andrea will drop that information in the feed for you. We do have information, visual information, that is on Ms. JaVon Butler's page as well, and also on our SeLah Production Incorporated Facebook page. So please, by all means, okay, head over to those pages, check out those resources, and if you would like to donate, once again, to SeLah Productions Incorporated, go ahead and do so now. We appreciate it so much. Of course, you guys know we're doing so much work in the community and now nationwide, worldwide.
Yes.
Okay, so we just thank you guys so, so much for all of your love and all of your support here at SeLah Productions Incorporated, also with SeLah Spot, and all of the other things that God has placed on Ms. JaVon's heart and placed in front of her so that she can run towards the vision, all right? Miss Andrea, did you have any other notes that you wanted to...
I'm excited about this word, so I'm going to get out the way so that the word can go forth.
Absolutely, absolutely. Y'all show some love to Miss Andrea Hollins, all right? Award-winning Chief Operating Officer, award-winning stage manager, okay? So listen, what I'm going to do at this time, if I can get a source with my people, I want to give my shout-outs, y'all. I want to show some love and give my shout-outs. So I can show some love to our loyal viewers of SeLah Spot, all right? Guys, listen, we're about to get into this word. We have a wonderful, wonderful word for you guys on tonight. Of course, man, this is the place where you come and get the tea and everything that is going on with SeLah Productions Incorporated. However, we will be doing you a disservice and we will be doing ourselves a disservice if we didn't take this opportunity every week to come out and inspire you and aspire to inspire, as we do here at SeLah Productions Incorporated, man. So that's what we want to do. We thank you guys so, so much for joining us weekly, okay? We thank you guys so, so much. So let's see. I got a few shout-outs I want to give. Let me see if I can pull it up just a little bit closer. But here we go, guys. Our word for tonight, we are coming from 1 Chronicles chapter 4, verse 10. Once again, that is 1 Chronicles chapter 4, verse 10. Now, for my people who are on tonight, we're talking about seed sowing, okay? But we're going to dig a little deeper on tonight, all right? So at this point, what I'm going to do, okay, I'm going to bring in my favorite co-host, okay? Miss Renitra Jones is in the building, man. Y'all show some love. Put some hearts on the screen for Mrs. Renitra Jones. She is here with me on tonight once again. I am so glad that Miss Renitra is here with me on tonight. Y'all put some hearts on the screen. How you doing, Miss Renitra?
Okay.
All right, sliding in, absolutely. How you feeling?
Doing great.
Doing great. Good to see everyone. Got your notes. Cool. So, okay. Bernice Scott in the building, Elmira Shaw, Elton Fluence. Thank you guys so much for joining us here at the spot. Listen, I hope that God is blessing you real good. Please stick around. We have a wonderful, wonderful show for you guys on tonight and an awesome word for you guys on tonight. All right, Miss Renitra. Mm-hmm. You know, in your own special way, go ahead and holler at the people, ask them to give you some hearts on the screen.
Hello, everyone. Good evening. I miss you all.
Absolutely.
And in the spirit of missing me, may I please have some hearts?
Put some hearts on the screen for Miss Renitra, y'all. Absolutely, absolutely. Yay. Once again, we encourage you guys to go ahead and share this video with your friends. Go ahead and invite people to join us. Man, listen, we have a wonderful word for you guys on tonight. And listen, man, we're going to get straight into it, okay? So go ahead and share. Go ahead. Once again, we encourage dialogue. We encourage you guys to comment, talk to us, okay? Because we're going to show you guys some love back, all right? So let's go, Miss Renitra. 1 Chronicles chapter 4, verse 10, okay? So it's a continuation, of course. It says, "And Jabez called on the God of Israel, saying, Oh, that you would bless me indeed and enlarge my territory, that your hand would be with me, and that you would keep me from evil, that I may not cause pain. So God granted him what he requested." Now, I'm going to read that again. Once again, guys, we're coming from 1 Chronicles chapter 4, verse 10. It says, "And Jabez called on God of Israel, saying, Oh, that you would bless me indeed and enlarge my territory, that your hand would be with me, and that you would keep me from evil, that I may not cause pain. So God granted him what he requested." Now, just reading it, right, it seems like, you know, just a simple passage, right?
A simple prayer.
Very, very simple prayer. Yeah. Absolutely. Yes. Very simple passage. Very simple prayer. And it is. Mm-hmm. It is.
It is.
And when put into its proper context, you know, we can see sometimes just how simple things can be, right? Mm-hmm. What I want you guys to do, if you're watching right now, I want you to put on the screen, "Enlarge my territory." Yes.
They may appear to be simple.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Enlarge my territory on the screen, guys. Mm-hmm. Enlarge my territory. I want to see it on the screen. Once again, enlarge my territory.
Enlarge my territory.
Ms. Renitra, I want to ask you, and then, you know, I'm going to get your thoughts, and then I'll share my thoughts. Mm-hmm. When you first read this scripture, what was your first thought?
Well, knowing the story behind Jabez, mm-hmm, and the lineage that he come from,
yeah,
it was a lot of pain.
Mm-hmm.
It was... I felt like he was coming from a place like, God, I am tired.
Yeah.
You know what my struggles have,
yes,
been. All I ask, Lord, I'm just out of words to say.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just going to say this simple prayer. Please enlarge my territory.
Yes.
What does he say? Oh, that you would bless me.
Yes.
Just bless me, Lord, and enlarge my territory.
Absolutely.
And I feel like his heart was so heavy.
Mm.
It's like God knows your heart. He knows what's in your heart.
Yeah.
And what's in your intention. To where you don't have to have all the most eloquent words to say to God.
Mm-hmm.
God feels what you're going through.
Yeah.
God, please, what I'm going through,
mm-hmm,
enlarge my territory.
Yes.
I am tired.
Yeah. Oh no, you're good. You're good. Absolutely.
Yes. Yes.
Absolutely. So, kind of, you know, as you did, when I first read it, you talked about his lineage and
mm-hmm,
you know, what had happened previously. The first thing I did, I went to the verse right before.
Mm-hmm.
And it said, it talked about how he was honorable. And he was an honorable man.
Mm-hmm.
So, because I was sitting here wondering, I said, okay, he called out that, you know, that simple prayer. I was like, I wonder why, you know, why it was so that it was just granted to him and requested just like that. you know? Mm-hmm. And I began to think about, you know, some of the things that we've talked about here on the spot about just about obedience, right? Mm-hmm. And just about being honorable, mm-hmm. right? And that's the first thing that came to my mind. As I continued to dig deeper into it, I thought to myself, we talk a lot about the prerequisites and making ourselves available for mm-hmm. God to use us, right?
Yes, yes.
So here, he called on God, yeah. right? Now, a part of calling on God is knowing that you can call on God, right?
Right.
Knowing that you are capable of calling on God. Yeah. Oh, that you would bless me indeed. He was crying out. Oh, that you would bless me indeed and enlarge my territory, that your hand would be with me and that you would keep me from evil, that I may not cause pain. Knowing that lineage that you talked about, knowing what he came from, and understanding that you can call on God mm-hmm. to be blessed. Mm-hmm. And, you know, sometimes it may take a little longer mm-hmm. for you to reap
for
what you sow. Absolutely.
Yes.
But sometimes God will just thrust it upon
He'll just grant it. Because you know why? Sometimes God is just waiting on us. He's like, well, I have the answer. I was just waiting on you to stop trying to figure it out for yourself.
Yes.
And call on me.
Call on me, yes.
I had the answer, but you wanted to, you know, try to fix it on your own.
Yeah.
I have the answer. God is just saying, I have the answer.
Absolutely.
But I don't know why we as people, we always we try to figure it out for ourselves and figure out, okay, God, just give me the wisdom to do how you want me to do this. But sometimes God just simply wants us to say, call unto him.
Yes.
And let him do all of the things, you know. Let him assign the angels. Let him assign the people in your life to just make the pathway, just open it up.
Absolutely.
Just open the doors.
I'm glad you said that.
Yes.
I'm so glad you said that about opening the doors.
Yes.
Opening
yes.
things up, right?
Yes.
Because we, of course, on tonight, here's the thing. We're talking about enlarging our territory, right?
Yes.
But you know, we had a conversation earlier, mm-hmm. and we was talking about, see, there's certain things that open things up
That's
more,
right.
right?
That's right.
So sometimes the door may be cracked, mm-hmm. but there are things that we can do, mm-hmm. and there are things that we can put resources into. Mm-hmm. To where the floodgates are open.
They were
right?
open.
On tonight, guys, we are talking about seed sowing. Mm-hmm. We are talking about seed sowing on tonight. But we want to talk about, just briefly, the attitude of seed sowing. Mm-hmm. Right? Mm-hmm. So, Ms. Renitra, and we both can speak to this. We have seen seed sowing work tremendously in our lives, right? Mm-hmm. Let's just talk real briefly about the spirit of seed sowing, how sometimes it, you know, it may be difficult to sow a seed into something, especially when, you know, it's a hard seed to sow,
yeah,
right? Especially
right.
when we're thinking about our lives in the natural, we're thinking
right.
about our own personal finances.
Right.
If you wanted to start off with that, or you wanted me to start, however you want to do it.
Well, I will say, when it comes to seed sowing, yes, we may talk about money, but seeds are not always monetary.
Correct.
Seeds can be the time that you put into a person that is in need.
Yes.
You know, God may speak to you and say, you know, you have this gift or this talent. Mm-hmm. I want you to just be a blessing to these people.
Absolutely.
And it's just simply that, you know, oh, that you will bless me and enlarge my territory. Mm-hmm. So we're asking God to bless us.
Yeah.
But who are we? It's like a reciprocation.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Who are we blessing in return for
yes.
God opening up the doors to enlarge our territory?
Indeed.
So,
indeed, absolutely.
You know, and but that, seeds, yes.
Yeah, mm-hmm. and it's very important to understand what you just said, mm-hmm. because so many times people get caught up in the monetary part of
yes.
it, which, don't get me wrong.
Yeah, it's
listen,
necessary.
Absolutely,
yes.
absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
But sometimes it can be beyond that.
Yes.
Right? So we have to be a service mm-hmm. To the kingdom, right?
Right.
Ms. JaVon talks all the time about You know, if you want something from God, you have to deposit something right. into it. So
give him something to work with.
Absolutely. Okay. Absolutely. Man, listen, you know, you can't, a plant can't grow.
You know, if you don't put a seed in there.
Absolutely. Okay. Absolutely. So
you got to water it too.
Right. Okay. Right. We're going to get yes. into that in a second. Yes. But here's the thing, just about the spirit of seed sowing. Mm-hmm. You have to give willingly, right? You can't give with an attitude and expect, what's the saying say, you reap what you sow. Mm-hmm. Now, here's the thing. Sometimes we give, but we give with a bad attitude. Listen, yes. God is always watching us.
He wants a cheerful giver.
A cheerful giver, yes. Absolutely. So the thing is, we have to understand at all times when we're giving, we give with a full heart. Mm-hmm. And not looking for something in return, yes. but understanding that you are giving and you are sowing into the kingdom.
Unto God.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Yes.
So when we do these things, we don't necessarily look for something in return. Mm-hmm. Now, we understand that we serve a gracious God and that he will bless us. Mm-hmm. But sometimes we go looking and we get discouraged because things don't come back to us right away. Mm-hmm. Well, sometimes it just doesn't work like that. Mm-hmm. Sometimes we don't get things back right away. But we understand who God is and we understand what God will bless us with. Man, we just give because we want to serve God.
Yes.
You know, a lot of the things I do, you know, personally, with, like you said, with my gift, with my talent, mm-hmm. it's just me giving it to God. Mm-hmm. You know, knowing that, hey, I may not get something back in return right away, but understanding that I have to sow into the kingdom of God mm-hmm. in order to reap the benefits of the kingdom of God.
Yes.
So, I'll talk a little bit about how when I first read, once again, guys, we're coming from 1 Chronicles chapter 4, verse 10, okay? 1 Chronicles chapter 4, verse 10. But I talked a little bit about how I backtracked a little bit. And it talked about how he was honorable, mm-hmm. right? He was honorable.
Yes.
And, you know, it seems to me, when I put it in its proper context, that played a big part in God granting his wishes and God answering his prayers, mm-hmm. right? We can't just be out here living any kind of way and expect those abundant blessings.
Yes.
You know, of course, you know, sometimes, you know, God, he'll show you some love.
Right? Right, right.
But those abundant blessings, those over-the-top blessings, mm-hmm. comes from serving him, mm-hmm. comes from being obedient. What's your take on that?
Well, our blessing for serving him and being obedient to him. I'm just trying to gather my words, mm-hmm. but yes, God is looking for us to be, it's a requirement.
Yes.
We have to be obedient to his word. We also have to be open and have a relationship with him where we can hear
yes,
from him.
Absolutely.
But, I don't know. That's all I have to say on that one.
Absolutely. So one thing that I kind of thought about, mm-hmm. you know, as I said, the saying goes, you reap what you sow. Mm-hmm. How can you possibly reap the rewards of something that you did not sow into, mm-hmm. right? So if on an everyday basis,
yeah.
we're not sowing into things that represent our Father, that represent the kingdom, mm-hmm. how can we expect to reap things and to gain things that are representative of higher, mm-hmm. that are representative of a higher calling, something that will bring us higher and lift us higher,
yes,
right?
Yes.
So we have to sow into things that are of God.
Yes.
We have to sow into things that push the kingdom forward and pushes God's message forward, right?
That's right.
We can't just be going out and sowing into anything because the things that are going to come from that may not yes. be reflective of the God that we serve.
It may be a good thing, but it's not a God thing.
God thing. Yeah. Absolutely. Absolutely. Yes. So I would just encourage our viewers yes. to be mindful, you know, of what they are sowing into.
Right.
And once again, it's not just money.
Yeah.
It's your time. It's your resources.
Yes.
It's your mind.
Yes.
The things that you're feeding into on a daily basis.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to be very, very mindful of that and make sure that we are honorable and make sure that, you know, when God looks at us, he sees someone who is representative of his kingdom.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? We have to, man, I can't stress this enough.
Yes.
when we want to serve God, we have to make sure that we're serving God at all times and we're being, you know, a reflection of Jesus Christ,
That's
right?
That's correct.
You know, we have to walk in the footsteps of Jesus Christ. So when we're sowing into his kingdom, we want to make sure that we're sowing with a full heart, make sure that we're serving him wholeheartedly and not expecting something in return. But of course, as children of God, we know that he will bless us, okay? But we can't just give just to say, okay, I'm going to get something back, right?
Yeah, right, right.
Absolutely. So let's shift gears for a second, Ms. Renita. Let's shift gears for a second. You know, here we like to kind of put things into context, okay? Now, we had a brief conversation earlier. You know, sometimes we sow the seed, but we don't do the work that's required.
That's correct.
After we sow the seed.
Mm-hmm.
Talk a little bit about that, if you don't mind.
Well, as you're giving, God always gives us instructions.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes we can become slothful. Okay, God, I sowed the seed. Now, you know, just bless me.
Yeah.
But in addition to sowing the seed, there may be other instructions where, okay, I want you to go to this location.
Mm-hmm.
Or I want you to, not even when it comes to sowing the seed, you may say, well, I couldn't reach this person that you told me to bless. But I found the next best person that I thought needed that blessing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think that can sometimes set us back, you know, in our enlargement of the territory, you know?
Yes.
So it's being obedient to how God tells you to do the blessing.
Mm-hmm.
So, and it's a lesson. You know, we all have to learn. Do we make mistakes? Do we not follow A, B, and C? We've all done it.
Yes.
But we have to just learn how to, you know, just be more aware of the procedure of how to bless and be specific. If you're not sure, okay, God, I need you to be like more, give me more details of exactly who it is that you want me to bless.
Mm-hmm.
I want to do it in the right timing because, you know, and I was going to talk about this, later on, but like as in Ecclesiastes 3 and 1 through 8, you know, it talks about there's a time and there's a season for everything, you
Absolutely.
Know, a season for every activity under the heavens.
Mm-hmm.
Are you operating in the right time and season?
Yes.
That's just the bottom line about opening, enlarging our territories,
yes.
you know? The open doors, the blessing, the increase in our lives, knowing when, understanding the timing.
Mm-hmm.
So,
yes. And absolutely, timing is always very important.
Yes.
Just as, you know, someone who would work on a farm. They know when it's time to plant certain seeds, right?
That's right.
So, you know, let's make that, let's translate that to real life. Let's translate that to the kingdom work that we're doing, right? So if we're listening and we're understanding what God is telling us, and like you said, if we're listening to the directions, understanding the procedure, we will know what time and season to sow into certain things, okay?
Right.
So when we're doing that, of course, you're going to sow that seed. However, you have to continue to work that seed, right? You have to continue to work it. A farmer doesn't plant the seed and then just walks away and leaves it and say, okay, okay, God, it is what it is.
Yes.
No, you have to continue to work that seed. Once you plant that seed, once you sow that seed, you have to water that seed.
Yes.
You have to make sure that seed is in a position, right? In a position to get sunlight, correct? So you can't just plant it in anywhere, right? Where it's going to be covered up, it's not receiving any sunlight, right? So you don't plant your seed in a position where it can't get what it needs in order to be blessed, in order to sprout, in order to take you to that next level, in order to enlarge your territory.
Yes.
No, God is telling you exactly where to plant your seed, when to plant your seed. However, you have to be consistent in connecting with him, in praying to him.
Right.
So you can have that understanding, right?
That's the key.
Because if you plant your seed somewhere where it's not going to get any sunlight and you can't constantly give it water, it's never going to grow. Mm-hmm. However, God is going to give you the instructions to put your seed in a position.
Yes.
To position it, right? Put yourself in position to plant that seed to where when you do plant it, you are responsible to give it the proper care that it needs, right?
Yes.
He's giving you the instructions already.
Right.
He's giving you the instructions. You know where to go. You know how to go about it, right? Mm-hmm. Now it's up to you, okay? You are responsible. I'm responsible.
Yes.
Ms. Renisha is responsible, okay?
And what is that responsibility? It's your prayer.
Absolutely.
It's your daily prayer. God, look, I know I did not sow this seed in vain.
Mm-hmm.
I did not sow it out of selfishness to expect something in return.
Yes.
But yes, but we are expecting something.
Yes.
You know, will it happen immediately? But we have to always be mindful. How do you water that seed?
Mm-hmm.
You have to pray.
Yes.
And you it's like you set your mind on, God, I have asked you for these things.
Mm-hmm.
I have sown into your kingdom, Father
mm-hmm.
God. I have not only have I used my money and my resources, I have given my time, Father.
Mm-hmm.
You know, just please remember me. Remember your servant,
yes.
Lord.
Yes.
You know? And I ask that these wishes be granted unto me.
Mm-hmm.
And this is what the prayer of Jabez
absolutely.
Is pretty much saying.
Yep.
God knew his heart.
Mm-hmm.
He knew where he come from, you know? He knew the desire that he had to want to see a change.
Mm.
He's like, now, Lord, I need an enlargement.
Yep.
When? It's enough. I've been in this for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
I've been doing the work.
Yeah.
I'm ready to see my harvest.
Yep.
Are you?
Yeah.
Are you watering your harvest?
Mm-hmm.
Are you nurturing your harvest?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Oh no, you're good. Absolutely.
Yes.
And you talked a little bit about that expectancy, right?
Yes.
Now where does that expectancy come from? That expectancy
yes.
comes from knowing
yes.
who you're serving.
Yes.
And knowing where the intention
yes.
for you sowing that seed comes from.
Right.
Because
right.
you know, I can walk out of here right now and just give somebody $100 and expect something in return, but that's the wrong kind of expectancy.
Right. Mm-hmm.
That's the wrong kind of expectancy. But when I'm in constant prayer and understanding where my instructions come from and
mm-hmm.
being consistent, being constantly connected with God, now I know exactly where I should go,
mm-hmm.
exactly where I'm being led, what direction I'm being led in, right? So because of that, when I do sow that seed, I have the spirit of expectancy
mm-hmm.
because I know that the seed that I've sown, it comes from straight from instructions from God.
That,
right?
That is correct.
It comes straight from the instructions,
that is.
Right? It's almost like, you know, man, me and my analogies, right? Okay, you know, you can buy seeds, right?
Mm-hmm.
You can buy seeds to plant, and it'll give you the instructions.
Mm-hmm.
It'll tell you exactly how to do it.
Mm-hmm.
I expect for that plant to grow
mm-hmm.
because that is what the instructions told me,
mm-hmm.
okay? So when I'm in constant prayer, and connecting with God constantly, and I know the instructions that He has given me. When I do sow that seed, I have the spirit of expectancy because I know what God has promised to me, right? And that is what Jabez is saying when he calls on God. Oh, that you would bless me indeed and enlarge my territory,
mm-hmm.
that your hand would be with me, and that
oh,
you would keep
Lord.
Me from evil,
now
that I may not
right
cause
there.
Pain.
Yes.
So God granted him what he requested.
Let your hand be with
you. Yeah.
Me. I mean, you know, really, Caitlin, that is usually my daily prayer.
Mm-hmm.
God, this in this thing called life,
mm-hmm.
I just ask that you just be with me, keep me,
yes,
keep me whole, keep me from harm. I know I may have to encounter some things that may hurt me.
Yeah.
But Lord, just make it a little easier for me to
absolutely.
Endure, you know? So, I, you know, this prayer, let your hand be with me.
Yes.
God, put me in that hiding place,
mm-hmm.
Lord. Look, hide me from my enemies.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just
yeah.
keeping it real.
Yeah.
Look, I know my enemies will come, but
mm-hmm.
God, I just ask that you just hide me sometimes. Because when you know that I am in a vulnerable state,
mm-hmm.
I need to be in a place where no one can find me.
Yes.
Because if they find me in this state right here, I don't know what I would do. Mm-hmm. I may lose my mind. I may do something that I really may regret. Absolutely. I will regret because God knows our state, our emotions, our moods at the time. He knows he needs to let the enemy like take us, hide us, So keep me from harm so that I will be free from pain.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. And something else that kind of grabbed me, okay?
Yes.
You know, like you said, that your hand would be with me.
Yes.
Here's the thing, okay? I talked a little bit about, knowing who we serve, right?
Yes.
And knowing where we get the instructions from. Now, there are some people who are going to see this, right? And they're saying, well, bro, I don't really know what you're talking about because I know where my instructions come from. I know that I've sowed my seed, but I haven't seen anything yet, okay? Here's the thing, man. Sometimes it doesn't happen overnight, okay? It doesn't happen in a week. It doesn't happen in a month. You know, sometimes it may take longer, but you have to continue to push forward. You have to continue to pray over that seed, because when you're praying for an enlargement in your territory, sometimes you may pray for, metaphorically, I'll just say 1 acre, right? And God is trying to give you 100 acres.
Mm-hmm.
God is trying to give you something bigger than you can even expect, right? But He's waiting for you to believe in that. He's waiting for you to believe in that seed that you sowed, right? So you have to continue to go to Him and continue to consult in Him, because He's going to let you know and He's going to push you in that right direction. If it hasn't come yet, keep moving.
That's
keep pushing.
Right.
Keep praying. Because at some point it's going to come and it's going to be bigger than you even expected, okay? But you have to understand that you can't give up on that seed.
Mm-hmm.
You can't give up. Sometimes it may just be a little sprout that comes up, but you got to keep watering it. You got to keep pushing toward what you're praying for, okay? It says, once again, it says, oh, that you would bless me indeed. Of course, Jabez, man, he was hurt. He was, like you said, heavy-hearted, okay? But he knew where to go. Oh God, that you would bless me indeed and enlarge my territory, that your hand would be with me,
yes,
and that you would keep me from evil, that I may not cause pain. So God granted him what he requested.
Yes.
Over time, things are going to get hard.
Yes.
Things, listen, it may not, like I said, it may not come right away. Most of the time, it's probably not going to come right away.
Right.
But you have to continue to show God that you have faith in that seed that you sowed. And like
yes,
you said, I did
yes,
not sow this seed in vain. I know that something is going to come from it, because it didn't come from just me saying, okay, I'm going to go do this. No, it came from God.
Yes.
It came from God putting that in your heart, putting that into your spirit to go ahead and sow that seed.
Yes.
So listen, it may have been, you may be watching this right now, it may have been 5 years, okay? But believe me, and this is not me saying this, this is coming from the Word, it will happen. God will enlarge your territory.
That's right.
If it came from God, God will not lie to you.
Yes.
He will enlarge your territory. That seed, you will reap the benefits of that seed that you sowed.
Yes.
But you have to continue to water that seed and push towards whatever it is that you are praying for. You have to continue to pray on that seed.
Yes.
Believe me.
Yes. Well, what I want to say, I kind of want to backtrack to when it says, let your hand be with me.
Yes.
And keep me from harm so that I will be free from pain.
Mm-hmm.
Well, while we have the hand of God on us, and we know when God's hand is upon us,
mm-hmm,
that should be a time for us to say, okay, now that your hand is with me, I want to have a deeper relationship with you.
Yes.
Lord, help me to understand you more.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Lord, you know everything that I'm doing. Lord, you understand my life purpose, my life goal. God, I'm just asking that while your hand is on me in my life, that you will help me to finish well.
Yes.
Let me just finish the task
yes,
that you have for me, Father
yes,
God. And, you know, I know it may sound like a cliche,
mm-hmm,
but I want to be more like you, Lord. Meaning, I just want to understand. I want to see things the way you see it. You know, I know we live in this big world with people with different perspectives.
Yeah.
But Lord, I want to know your perspective on life. I want to be able to teach the people. Mm-hmm. I want to be able to, you know, live out my purpose that you have for me.
Yes.
So that's what I'm saying. We have to always understand. I think that simple prayer of having your hand mm-hmm. on you, on me, that is just like the most nurturing thing any father can give.
Yeah.
Your hand is with me. Yes. You are with me. You are protecting me from harm.
Yeah.
So that's all I really wanted to say
to
on that.
To lead us to guide us, right? Mm-hmm. You know, that's what God is here.
Yes, yes.
To lead us and to guide us.
Yes.
And we should not be afraid to call on him.
Right.
We should not be afraid to ask big, okay?
Yes.
To ask for him to push us in the right direction, to ask him to enlarge our territory. But here's the thing. Here's what we have to understand. There are things, there are requirements. There are things that we have to do. We have to sow into the kingdom of God to reap the benefits of the kingdom of God, mm-hmm. okay? We can't just be out here just, you know, living our best life, right?
Right.
And, you know, just sowing into all of the wrong things.
Yes.
And expect to reap the full benefits of the kingdom of God.
Right.
Correct?
Right.
So that is why it is so, so, so important. You know, of course, we serve God. You know, of course, you know, sometimes we go through the motions. You know, we go to church and, you know, all of that.
Yes.
Wonderful.
Time after time.
Absolutely.
You know.
But there's something more that God requires of us.
Mm.
There's something more that God requires of us. And it's sowing into his kingdom.
Yeah.
And sowing into his kingdom and making it known that we believe that when we put something in, he's going to give us so much more.
Yes.
He's going to give us so much more if we're sowing based on what he has given us instructions to sow into.
You said it right there.
Mm-hmm.
Believing. Because I'm talking to the people that said, where, Kaylin, I go to church faithfully.
Yeah.
I have given my seeds. I've given $500 seeds. I've even given $2,000 mm-hmm. seeds. I'm still not seeing it.
Yeah.
But what you said was believing.
Yeah.
You have to, you know, don't just... I know we always, you know, some people got their little tally of, mm-hmm. okay, on this date I sold this. Mm-hmm. Okay, I didn't get that harvest yet.
Mm-hmm.
But the thing is, we have to check our heart.
Yeah.
And continue to remember these things, but continue to believe.
Yeah.
I just want to wake that person up that just said, you know what? I heard this time and time again. Nothing has changed in my life. Mm-hmm. My time has not come. I don't even see Ecclesiastes 1:8 even come to pass. Mm. But you just wait. Mm. Who spoke ill of the seeds that they have sown? Okay, God, I've given 5 years ago. I still didn't see that seed. I just want people to have a cheerful heart about this thing, you know, the thing of sowing seeds mm-hmm. and these simple prayers, you know, that we just ask God for. Just continue to believe. I just want to encourage the people, you know.
You talked a little bit. Go ahead.
We see the same. It's like, what do we do now? We mm-hmm. see the same thing over and over again. Mm-hmm. I'm tired.
Right.
Just like Jabez was like, mm-hmm. I'm tired. Now, my prayer is about to be simple. Look, Lord, I just need you to bless me and enlarge my territory.
Yes.
I'm at my wit's end mm-hmm. right now.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Now,
sometimes, I would, you know, here's the thing. You know, we talk about giving with a cheerful heart, right?
Yes.
And understanding who we serve, understanding that everything is, like you said, it's a time and a season for everything, right?
Yes, yes.
So everything is not going to come to pass when we want it to come to pass,
correct.
Right? However, you know, just because something hasn't come to pass yet, we can't live like we're just laboring, okay? Like, just live with regret, like, man, I sure hope that seed come to pass. No. Continue to just move forward, okay? Have that spirit of expectancy.
Yes.
But listen, man, You got to keep it moving. You got to keep it pushing. You got to pray over your seed. You got to water your seed, but be joyful about it. Be cheerful about it, okay? Things, sometimes it just don't work like that, y'all. It just don't work like that. We got to keep it pushing. What you got?
How you used to say it? You check yourself.
You got to catch yourself. Because a lot of times we'll sow a seed and we're expecting something right away.
Yes.
And when something doesn't happen right away, now all of a sudden we're sad.
Yeah.
Well, no. No, we're supposed to be giving with a joyful heart, right?
Mm-hmm.
We're supposed to be giving not even specifically because we want something.
Mm-hmm.
We give because we want to give.
Mm-hmm.
We give because we want to sow into the kingdom of God, right?
Yeah.
So, of course, we do have that spirit of expectancy and you know, knowing that God is going to bless us and enlarge our territory and give us something in return. But we don't let that determine how we live our lives
mm-hmm.
while we're waiting on that return. No.
Or how we give.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely.
Yes.
We don't let that affect that.
Yes.
Because so many times that can be a hindrance in the blessing that God has waiting for us.
That's
but we
right.
got to check ourselves.
You got to check yourself.
We got to check ourselves.
Check your heart.
Absolutely.
Check your intention.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Yeah. Intention.
Yes.
Huge.
Yes.
Huge.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why I say, when it comes from God, when we know it comes from God, it can be so much easier to move in that direction, right?
Mm-hmm.
It can be so much easier to sow that seed and be joyful because we know it's coming from God. Now listen, sometimes, you know, when it seems like it may be taking a while, you know, it can get difficult.
Mm-hmm.
However, that's what we're here. We're here to encourage you guys.
Mm-hmm.
We're here to let you know if you've been waiting and you've been waiting and you've been waiting for that thing to come into fruition. Believe me, if it came from God, now I can't speak on it if it came from somewhere else.
Mm-hmm.
If you had different intentions, you know, I can't speak for that. But I know that the word tells me when it comes from God and he gave you those specific instructions and you follow those instructions, believe me, it's going to come to pass. And that seed is going to grow and God will enlarge your territory. But you can't give up on that seed. Don't give up on God because he will not give up on you.
That's right.
Okay? You have to sow that seed and you have to, like you said, nurture that seed.
Nurture it.
You have to water that
seed.
Hang
in there. Hang in there. You know? Yeah.
No.
I clearly understand.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes we say we get just tired of just doing a good thing.
Mm-hmm.
And we just feel like we're being stumped on.
Yeah.
But we got to understand, we got to check ourselves.
You got to check yourself, yeah.
Who are we doing this for?
Mm-hmm.
Are we doing it for these people?
Yeah.
Or are we doing it for you, God?
Yeah. Or are we doing it for our own monetary gain?
Yes.
Right?
Just check yourself.
Yeah.
Check your intentions. Just every, you know.
Yeah. Yeah. And you know, and here's the thing. You know, another thing that kind of stood out to me.
Mm-hmm.
Listen, man. God knows everything before it even happens.
Sure,
you know what
yes.
I mean? So if you look at it, these scriptures, you know, they were written, okay? And it's kind of a precursor to what's happening now. So what's happening in my life? What's
mm-hmm.
happening in your life, right? So, you know, Jabez was tired. Some of you all are tired, right? But he put his trust in God.
Mm-hmm.
And he trusted in the things that he had done. And the honorable person that he was, right? And because of that, because his instructions came from God, he was blessed, right? So you are tired. You are tired. You may be tired, but you have to keep pushing. You have to keep praying. You have to keep working and laboring for that seed that you planted. For that thing that is within you and from that thing that you have planted inside of someone else or, you know, whatever you put your seed in, whatever you sowed that seed into, you can't give up on it. You can't give up on it because guess what? As soon as you walk away, it may sprout,
mm-hmm.
right? As soon as you walk away, but guess what? Now you can't reap the benefits from it because you walked away,
mm-hmm.
okay? So here's an opportunity for you to be rejuvenated, okay, in that seed that you sowed. In that seed that you sow, rejuvenated. If you're tired, we get it. Sometimes life can do that to you. But God says to persevere. Don't be weary in well-being and well-doing. Do not be weary in well-doing. You have to continue to push and to press and to pray and to water that seed. Because, man, we're in the position. God has given us the instructions, y'all. God has given us the instructions, but we have to be consistent. Mm-hmm. We can't consult with God one day and then forget about God and then come back and say, oh, God, remember when. No, we have to continue to be consistent because he's constantly giving us directions, and we do not want to miss it. Do we want to miss it?
Not at all.
We do not want to miss it at all. Now, Ms. Renisha, I know you had a couple of things that you wanted to end with on tonight.
Well, I just want to just, you know, at the end of this prayer, you know, it just simply said God granted his request.
Yeah.
So I just want to encourage the people, just continue, as Kaylin was saying, continue to nurture your prayers that you have sent, to nurture the seeds and that you have sown.
Yes.
And expect your request to be granted. It's just a level of expectation for your life, for the things that you have done. Expect the increase.
Yeah.
We are now in the month of April.
Absolutely.
Can we just make a declaration that this is going to be our month of increase?
Absolutely.
And as a matter of fact, it is April the 4th.
Absolutely.
So can we expect a double increase in our lives? Can you believe, don't just say it, but can you believe it in your heart? Can you make a declaration on your own life? Lord, today, starting today, I am enlarging my territory. I ask for an enlargement of my territory. I ask for open doors. I ask for you, Lord, to send the increase.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
As simple said.
Absolutely.
I just want to bless you all, encourage you all. I love you all. Stay encouraged. Stay in prayer. When you feeling weary, when you feeling like enough is enough, I'm tired of this, I'm tired of this church thing, I'm tired of this giving thing, I'm asking you, please, just think about it again. Give God another chance.
Yes.
Allow him to be a blessing in your life. Allow him to grant your request.
Yes. Yes.
Again, as my parting, I just want to encourage you all to read Ecclesiastes 3, 1 and 8. Understanding the timing and the season of everything.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay. Absolutely. You know, what I want to say, you know, before we get up out of here, guys, you know, we have to understand who God is. We also have to understand that God is constantly, he's always watching us. So show God what you are truly about. When you sowing them seeds, when you, you know, giving your time, when you're giving your money, when you're giving back your talents, understand that God is always watching. And you can ask for an enlargement of your territory. However, you're not going to get it if you're showing God that you're not ready for it. If you're not ready for the enlargement of your territory because of your daily actions or, you know, your relationship with God, you can show as much as you want, but it's not coming from a real place. So, like we said, you want to check yourself. And you want to understand that you have to constantly be in tune and be connected with your Father, so that when you do sow a seed, you're sowing based on the instructions that he has given you, so that your seed can be planted in the fertile ground that he has instructed you, and in the position so that it can receive all the attention that it needs, so that it can eventually come into fruition after you've done the work, after you've proven to God, and after you've done what it takes for that seed, for you to reap ultimately what you have sown. So I just want to leave you guys with that on tonight. Please continue to sow with a joyful heart. Continue to, you know, consult with God and understand where he wants you to sow, where he wants you to give your talent. You know, your finances that you've been blessed with, how he wants you to bless others. Continue to bless others, man. Listen, this is a season This is a season of growth, of increase, very, very, I guess you would say, fruitful time to sow. And we do not want you to miss it, guys. So please, by all means, man, if you're waiting on something, please continue to do it. Don't just wait. See, there's a difference between just waiting and being proactive in waiting. Yeah. Okay? Some people are just waiting. No, we want to be patient. We want to be patient. But at the same time, we want to be proactive. So we want to continue to move toward what God has given us and move toward the kingdom things that God has put into our lives. So, man, we love you. We want you to continue to sow into the things that God has given you, into the things that God has blessed you with. Listen, man, we definitely, definitely thank you guys so, so much for joining us on tonight. Listen, if you enjoyed the word on tonight, we ask that you, of course, we talked about, you know, sowing on tonight. We talked about sowing into SeLah. Listen, if God has come to you, if God has placed it on your heart to sow into what we're doing here at SeLah Productions Incorporated, of course, we have so, so many things that we're doing to give back to the community. Of course, we guys know that SeLah is a nonprofit organization. We give to so many charities, you know, based on the play that we're doing. So all of our public productions, we give back to the community. Of course, we are in the schools. We're showing love to the kids with JaVon Ophelia's Act, man. And of course, God is enlarging our territory. You know, we're not just, you know, in the river parishes. We're not just in Louisiana, not nationwide, but God has enlarged our territory worldwide. Mm-hmm. And we are just so, so thankful for that. We are so, so thankful for you. That you continue to support us. So on tonight, we asked for a $20 seed. A $20 seed into SeLah Productions Incorporated. As Miss Andrea was on earlier, she was talking about the different ways that you can sow into SeLah Productions Incorporated. Of course, you can use the Cash App, you can use PayPal, and you can also head over onto our website, www.selahproductionsincorp.org. You can hit the donate tab at the bottom of the screen. It's a yellow tab, yellow donate tab at the bottom of the screen. Go ahead and donate whatever's on your heart. We're asking for a $20 seed on tonight. Listen, man, it is a season of increase. Of course, it's double.
Yes.
4-4, man.
Yes, yes.
April 4th. Yes. Double increase. So make sure you don't miss it. We don't want you to miss it. Go ahead and sow your seed
today.
Before midnight.
Yes.
Before midnight, go ahead and sow your $20 seed into SeLah Productions Incorporated on tonight. Make sure, please, do not forget to name your seed.
Yes.
Name your seed so that we can pray for you and so that we can pray with you.
Yes.
So that we can help you do the work that is required after you sow your seed.
Yes.
So that we can help you to see it through and come into fruition.
And
right?
We be in agreement that you're territory will be enlarged.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Sow into fertile ground.
Please.
Amen.
Please, absolutely, amen. Absolutely. So once again, those things are all on Ms. Javon's page, which is the page that we are streaming from here on tonight.
Yes.
Also on our SeLah Productions Incorporated Facebook page, which you guys can go over and like. And also on our website, which is www.selahproductionsincorp.org. Okay? All of the ways that you can donate and sow into SeLah Productions Incorporated, you guys can check out all of that information. It was also left in the feed on tonight. So if you guys would like to check that out and get a visual, please head over to any of those platforms to go ahead and sow a seed. Once again, on tonight, we're asking for a $20 seed into SeLah Productions Incorporated on 4-4.
Yes.
Increase. Double increase on tonight.
Expect it.
Absolutely.
Yes.
To enlarge your territory, guys. Once again, before we get up out of here, I just want to say again, please, by all means, please, please, you've sowed that seed, put the work in. Do that seed justice, okay? Mm-hmm. Don't just sow the seed and walk away from it, okay?
Right.
Do it justice. Do what is required to see the blessings that God has for you, okay? Do what is required to see the enlargement of your territory, to see it through.
Yes.
You know, you may already be getting a little sneak peek of what's to come. Okay? But you have to continue to water that seed. You have to continue to develop the things that God has already shown you. Sometimes he'll show you a little bit of something, but it's up to you. We are responsible, okay? We are responsible to continue to develop the things that God has given us, okay? Sometimes he may show us a little bit and there's something on the other side, but we miss it because we're like, oh, okay, that's it. Mm-hmm. No, continue to water that seed. Continue to pray. And pray seriously. Mm-hmm. Pray seriously and understand that what God has for you is something that, man, you can't even imagine. We can't even comprehend it with our small minds at times, right? Yeah. So please, please. And here's the thing. I can't tell you what blessings God has for you. Ms. Renitra can't tell you what blessings God has for you. But you have to go to God. You have to go to the source. You have to go to the source of the blessings. You know, I can't necessarily bless you per se, right? You know, I can take what God has given. If God has given something to me to give to you, then I can. But it's not, I'm not the source. It doesn't come from me, okay? It comes from God. So you are responsible. It is up to you. It is up to you to take that responsibility. Even if you sold that seed 5 years ago, you still have to take initiative and be proactive in your patience. Don't just wait, okay? Be patient, but be proactive in your patience by praying. I like that. I think Ms. JaVon would have liked that one. Be proactive in your patience by praying, okay? So once again, guys, thank you guys so much for joining us. Listen, man, go ahead and sow with what God has instructed you to sow into. Of course, we ask that you sow into SeLah's Productions Incorporated. Once again, guys, we're asking for a $20 seed on tonight. Go ahead and sow that before midnight, man, because they're double blessings on tonight.
Oh, yes.
Okay? April 4th, okay? 4-4, April 4th, double increase, man. Make sure you guys go ahead and sow that seed, man. And once again, please make sure you name your seed, okay? Mm-hmm. Name that seed. So that we can pray for you, yes. That we can pray for with you.
I have a simple name for the seed tonight. Mm-hmm. Enlargement.
Enlargement.
Name Absolutely. Your seed. $20 seed.
Absolutely.
Amen.
Enlargement. And once again, the different platforms that you can donate to. Once again, that's PayPal, Cash App, and also our website, which is www.selahproductionsincorp.com. org, okay? Mm-hmm. www.selahproductionsincorp.org, all right? So once again, guys, we love you.
Yes.
Man, we love you so, so much, which is why we are so passionate when we continue to bring this word forth to you. Please understand that, man, when we're preaching this to you, we're applying this in our lives as well every single day. So listen, just look at it as we're on a journey together, okay? Mm-hmm. We're on a journey together. Our SeLah's Spot family, we are on a journey together. So once again, man, we thank God for this platform. We thank God for in advance for the enlargement of our territory.
Amen.
We thank God in advance for the blessings that he has for us and for all of the things that he is going to do in our lives and in your lives individually.
Yes.
We thank God for our director, playwright, producer, visionary, Ms. JaVon Ophelia Butler, for seeing this vision through, for doing all the sowing that she has done.
Yes.
Right?
Right.
And because of that, SeLah has been blessed.
Right.
Because of that, we have been blessed, you know. So we just thank God for her. I thank God for the staff, Ms. Renice, for Ms. Andrea, who was on earlier. And guys, we thank God for you.
Yes.
You know, you guys have showed us so much love over the last year plus.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yes. So we just thank God for you, man. We hope that God continues to bless you real good.
Right.
Okay? And man, listen, I did get the blessing to make this announcement. Listen, guys, we will not be on next Thursday, okay? We will not be on next Thursday. But, man, please stay in the loop because y'all know if SeLah's Spot is not on, that means something else is going on, okay? Mm-hmm. So please, you know, stay in tune with Ms. JaVon's page, with the SeLah Productions page, because there is a lot going on with SeLah Productions Incorporated right now, okay? But we will be back to our regularly scheduled program on April 18th, okay? April 18th, we will be back. So we thank you guys so, so much. We love you, and we hope that God is blessing you real, real good. Once again, make sure you sow that seed, and we will see you guys in 2 weeks, all right? Much love and many blessings. Hope God is blessing you real good.